Experts say the U.S. could soon see as many as 200,000 cases a day.
There's a long line of people trying to get on their ships, and the price of freight has gone through to the moon.
Feels like Hurricane Ida hit southeast Louisiana 3 weeks ago and never left.
Katie, well, the big change from yesterday here in Terrebonne Parish is that reentry is now allowed, but that is enter at your own risk.
Building a research vessel is an enormous undertaking, wrought with unexpected challenges. Hurricane, pandemic, global supply chain crisis, all of these have exacerbated the challenge of building these floating laboratories. But despite this, progress persists in Louisiana.
Grew up in this back subdivision area here. And all this area on the side, this used to all be a railroad track along this, basically this area used to be a railroad in the middle of, on this little levee section right here. I mean, I grew up into this industry. My dad's ran shipyards all of his life. I mean, by the time I was about, I guess, six, we were taking crew boats out. That's what I grew up doing. You know, everybody always thinks about New Orleans when you talk about Louisiana. You know, we're an hour south of New Orleans, so nobody ever thinks about this little town. There wasn't a roof left on none of these houses and none of this area here after that, you know, after the storm. See, this used to be a building right here that got knocked down for the storm. That gas station is still missing its whole canopy top right here. They're still probably dealing with insurance problems. A lot of businesses wasn't open. Getting fuel at the time was an issue. The shipyard had challenges as well, bringing in water, bringing in fuel, managing, you know, those things on top of the storm damages is tremendous on all fronts. As far as where the boats are at now, yeah. Construction's in a better phase now. Well, at the end of the day, when this ship is going to go to work, there's not going to be many things that this vessel won't be able to do. It's all about what the next challenge is going to be.
Meanwhile, the RCRV team prepares for one of its biggest milestones yet, the launch of the RV Tani. Launching a vessel means that it's ready to be set into the water.
So today was the launch of the first vessel. They had transporters, which are big rollers underneath the ship. We actually rolled the ship onto the dry dock. They moved the dry dock over with tugs with the vessel on it. We did final inspections, and then we went ahead and started submerging the dry dock, which allowed the vessel to float. This was the first time we've had an RCRV actually, you know, hit the water. Went really well. The boat came off the blocks. We did our inspection while the boat was at like a 5-foot draft just to make sure there was no leaks. But as soon as you start to feel like the boat kind of come off the blocks a little bit and float, that's when people started to get really excited. We still have quite a few electrical cables to be pulled. Starting up the equipment, light off of the equipment, sea trials, dock trials. So we have quite a bit of work still to be done, but this is, again, a huge moment.
Launching a vessel moves the RV Tani closer to the next major phase in the RCRV construction process, outfitting. Back in Oregon, preparations have been underway to procure, test, and install a large amount of equipment into each of these vessels.
This is probably, right now we figure we've got about 70% maybe here on site, maybe a little more than that. Everything you need on a vessel to make it an operating vessel is what we're procuring, and it's thousands and thousands of items. And this is just the outfitting stuff. So all the things like the sensors and all that stuff, that's in a separate area. My job is to manage the outfitting and integration of the vessel into the academic research fleet. So not only do we have to get everything onto the vessels in order to make functional vessels, but we also have to baseline everything on there. So when they become an operational vessel, one, everything works and does what it was supposed to do, but also we know exactly how it's going to do that.
The RCRV Data Presence and Engineering Support Center, RDESC, is integrating an advanced sensor suite on these vessels. Through a web-based front end, observations happening on the boat will be made available to remote participants in near real time. This means sensor data, cruise chart, and more are available for a shoreside team to conduct science while the vessel is out at sea.
So right now, we've just brought in all of our computing systems, all of our sensor systems for vessel one, and deployed everything. Everything's running in the lab in much the same way it would be running on the ship. And we're burning it in, we're testing it, we're looking for problems, we're making sure it behaves the way it's expected to. Then we're gonna pack everything up from this facility, ship it to the shipyard, unpack it there and install it on the boat, and the expectation is that it'll come right back up.
We have a really impressive data presence structure both on the vessel and offering to shoreside participants for cruises or people who are interested in the data that we're doing. It's an overwhelming amount of new systems, and so we had a workshop where in December where the OIs were able to come and actually spend time together to talk through all the new cyber infrastructure that's going in, all the new sensors, and what that data presence is going to look like for those new sensors. So there's a lot to train ourselves on. We're doing a lot.
When our scientists come onto the vessel, they know exactly what they're going to expect out of the scientific capabilities of the vessel. That's our job, is to get them fully scientific operational, and we have 1 year after delivery in order to do that.
Progress continues for all three vessels, with the RV Narragansett Don nearing launch and modules for the RV Gilbert R. Mason well underway. The challenges that construction brought are only the beginning of the next phases, which include testing the intricate systems being installed by the RDESC team.
This particular research boat has some of the most sophisticated equipment that I've ever seen on any vessel in the world.